Hello everybody, and welcome back to Canned Goods, the show all about the movies that we'll never see. I love Pixar. Toy Story, Monsters, Inc., The Incredibles, some of my favorite movies ever made. And on top of that, they're just really well-made movies. They're still cranking out fantastic movies to this day, but today, I want to focus on a younger Pixar. That golden era, 2000s Pixar, that was pretty much untouchable in terms of quality. The Pixar that gave us movies like Ratatouille and Up. The Pixar that never canceled films. But what if I told you that somewhere along the way, there was one movie that slipped through the cracks? Well, that's what we're going to talk about today when we break down the production and cancellation of the lost Pixar movie, Newt. Newt was announced in 2008 at a Disney animation presentation alongside Up, Toy Story 3, Cars 2, and The Bear and the Bow. The announcement of the movie itself seemed very indicative of its tone. The film's would-be director Gary Rydstrom trotted out on stage with this tongue-in-cheek, really detailed chart about Newt mating, just kind of playing up the slightly offbeat angle the movie was going for. Rydstrom explained that Newt, our quirky main character, had been held in captivity in a lab since he was a tadpole, with his only friend being a sock puppet. And every day, Newt sees this mating chart from his cage, and he practices the mating ritual while he waits for the scientists who take care of him to capture him a girlfriend. Little does he know that he's one of the last blue-footed newts on Earth. The other newt of the movie was named Brooke. She's been living in the wild, also completely unaware that she was one of the last of her kind. Brooke eventually gets captured and put together with Newt, and they have what Rydstrom described as the worst first date ever. They eventually wind up in the wild, and that's where our story would really begin. The presentation ended with a summer 2011 release date and a press release which read, "What happens when the last remaining male and female blue-footed newts on the planet are forced together by science to save the species, and they can't stand each other?" That's the problem facing Newt and Brooke, the heroes of Newt. The Pixar film by the 7-time Academy Award winner for sound, Gary Rydstrom, and the director of Pixar's Oscar-nominated short, Lifted. Newt and Brooke embark on a perilous, unpredictable adventure and discover that finding a mate never goes as planned, even when you only have one choice. Love, as it turns out, is not a science. After Newt's announcement, it was presumed that the movie was moving forward along with all the other movies that Pixar announced at this presentation. Sure, nobody heard about it for 2 years, but that wasn't exactly uncommon to hear a movie get announced and for it to fall by the wayside while the movies that are closer start to get talked up. But behind the scenes, however, something seemed to be very wrong. The Animation Guild blog is a blog where professional animators of the local chapter 839 will go and talk about the latest and greatest news in the world of animation. The leaders of the guild will post their observations and thoughts about the current going-ons in the animation industry, and all the other animators in the chapter would talk about it in the comments. On February 9th, 2010, Steve Hewlett, who was the guild's business representative at the time, posted about how he was at Disney Studios and he mentioned Rapunzel, the movie we would come to know as Tangled, and that he knew a name change for Rapunzel was probably coming. That obviously came to pass. He also mentioned how The Snow Queen, the movie that would eventually become Frozen, was being shelved for the time being. One of the readers of this post was none other than Floyd Norman, one of the most seasoned animation veterans out there. He worked at Hanna-Barbera, Disney, Pixar. He had a hand in movies from Sleeping Beauty to Monsters, Inc. He worked under Walt Disney himself. Long story short, this guy knows his stuff. And in some of the comments on the thread, he lamented at the state of Disney, bending Rapunzel's title to Tangled, shelving the Snow Queen. And completely out of nowhere, he lamented about Newt being canceled. And all things considered, he dropped that piece of important information pretty casually. Fast forward to April 2010. Disney and Pixar hold another presentation like the one in 2008. Up, which is the first movie Pixar announced in 2008, was released a year ago to huge critical acclaim. Toy Story 3, another movie they announced back then, was about 2 months out from release and things were looking very promising. So riding high on their success and goodwill, Pixar came out and did its presentation. They announced Monsters, Inc. 2, which we'd come to know as Monsters University. The Bear and the Bow would get retitled to Brave, but they didn't mention Newt at all. Which is weird, because like I said, the movie was slated to drop in summer of 2011. But Brave was dropping Christmas of 2011. So the fact that we heard more about Brave than Newt, things were definitely looking a little suspect. Around that time, Disney started wiping away all references to Newt. Chief among them was the movie being quietly removed from Disney's official A to Z encyclopedia, which was run by a guy named Dave Smith. And here's where the story starts to get a little vague, but from my understanding, a website known as the Pixar blog reached out to Smith and he sent back an email that had only 5 words. The film has been canceled. And I just want to put out there for transparency's sake, with all my research for this video, whenever that event is mentioned, that story is always 100% consistent, though I can't even find the original Pixar blog website, so that's worth mentioning. But it seemed like that was it. Newt was officially canceled. But that raises the question, why did it get canned? In May of 2011, IGN was interviewing John Lasseter, one of the key founders of Pixar, and Newt came up, and John mentioned, "We've put movies into development, and some get further than others, and then we feel like things just aren't quite ready, we put them to the side, and that's just been put on a shelf, and we'll see where that goes in the future." Lasseter continued and said, "Its story was very similar to a movie that's out in theaters right now with a blue parrot. Oh my. Wow, we were like, no. There was no, great minds think alike, I guess. It was really pretty similar." And obviously, the movie he's referring to is Rio. What's also interesting about his quote is that he never says that Newt is out and out canceled. And to be fair, you could chalk it up to Disney corporate speak, but the way he mentions that we'll see where it goes in the future, I wouldn't be surprised if this movie or elements of it resurfaced in a later Pixar movie. In my travels online, a lot of people seem to blame Rio for being the sole reason for Newt's cancellation, but it went deeper than that. Sure, Rio may have been a factor in Newt's cancellation, but there's one much more important reason. In 2014, Ed Catmull, who's one of the co-founders of Pixar, revealed that Newt wasn't really coming together as planned under Gary Rydstrom. So Pixar decided to bring in the now head of Pixar, Pete Docter, who was just coming off of massive success from Up. But when Pete came in, he told Pixar that he'd try and get Newt across the finish line, but that he had a different idea which he thought was a lot better. What was that idea? Inside Out. So in short, Newt was canceled so that Pixar could start making Inside Out. It is a real shame though that nothing beyond this concept art and that sticker in Toy Story 3 exists from Newt, because as similar as it seemed to Rio, it did seem to have enough differences of note to warrant its existence. I mean, the cast alone seemed to warrant this movie's existence. Ben Stiller, William Shatner, Dabney Coleman, this cast was great. But on the flip side, Inside Out is one of Pixar's best movies, and if we could only have one or the other, I'd probably trade Newt for Inside Out. So I'd say that Pixar ultimately made the right call. But that's the story of Newt, and the end of another episode of Canned Goods. So until next time, thank you for watching, have a beautiful day, and stay Hemmers.